This is how I made a logo for my YouTube channel in minutes using AI. It's incredible because I started a YouTube channel and the branding page is just looking rubbish. I mean, logo picture, nothing, banner image, nothing, no watermark. I need AI to assist me to make something incredible and maybe I can do it for free. I start out with Adobe Express, which is a popular free option. They have so much available for free inside the app. And right here inside New Creations, you can actually choose logo as an option. So it's brilliant. It gives you a nice canvas. It's square, just like a logo should be. And you can use generative AI to come up with ideas. So I'm going to click into square and select what I want. So I can choose the content type. Maybe we'll go for graphic, like so. This is interesting, but not quite what I had in mind. Let's try something else. And actually, Adobe Express has given me great stars and sparkles to start with if I want to start making that logo. Now, I could further iterate on that and make it pretty good right inside the free Adobe Express web app, which is pretty cool. But I wanted to play with some other generative AI and see what I could come up with. Midjourney is huge. I use that all the time, and I think it's a fantastic tool. Let's see what it can do for a logo. So here, I'm really specific. I want the sparkle style in my logo. So I uploaded that as a picture reference and then just referenced it a bunch of times. Magic and then the logo. But of course, I got wizardry things and great vast scenes. Maybe I needed to put vector logo, but it was kind of giving me weird stuff that wasn't really based on my initial upload. As you can see, it was giving me a bunch of different stuff. Using the keyword vector, clean and white background kind of helped to keep it more logo-like, but it was just too abstract, like too way out there for what I was looking for. I want something really simple. So finally, I hopped over here into ChatGPT and I actually used their latest DALL-E 3 model. And again, I uploaded the sparkles emoji and I said, create a vector logo from this icon. It's the sparkles emoji. And you know what? Straight away, it came up with a couple of great ideas, and I kind of like the way it's going with these ideas. I prompted it a few other times, and I said, just give me three sparkles and make them fill the whole image. It kind of didn't get that. It went wild and nuts, and I went on and I said again, but keep it really simple. It seems to love symmetry and everything being perfect. So I went on and said again, even simpler, and just got crazy, far out there, almost psychedelic stars. One more time, just one color and really simple. No, it's just multiple stars everywhere. One single star. Well, it gave me one single star, but it wasn't anything impressive. Keep the star in the shape of a sparkles emoji. And it just got worse and worse. So I just said, thanks. It said, you're welcome. And I actually rolled right the way back to the initial idea and downloaded this file because I think this has great potential. Remember, if you're enjoying this content, like and also subscribe to this channel so you can learn more AI tools for content creation. Now, I pulled it into Adobe Illustrator, and in its current form, it's not quite good, but there was a part of this logo I thought had potential. I'll show you what I did to it. First of all, I know this is an image, but with Adobe Illustrator, I can trace around it and vectorize it. Now, making a logo into a vector essentially means it's drawn lines that can be expanded and made as big as you want. So that's perfect for a logo because I can start with a small logo on a YouTube channel, but eventually I could blow it up and put it on a poster if I want to. So how do I do this in Illustrator? I just go into Image Trace, and then I've got a bunch of different options. I found the three colors option work the best. And what this actually does is traces around your whole image and pulls out just the stuff you look. And look at how clean that is when the process completes. I just click the quick action down here, expand, and it's going to nicely outline everything. Now, if I click ungroup up here, what it's going to do is allow me to select individual elements. So I can actually select just the part of the logo that I want, which is just this section. I'll command C, copy it, and then I'll start a brand new file in Illustrator. Let's have it as a web file, which is a nice square. It's exactly what we want. Command or Control V, paste those stars. Now, they're a little bit small, but because I've vectorized them, I can grab and I can drag. Now, obviously, they're losing the size proportions there. If I hold down the Shift key, it'll expand them in size like that and keep everything nice. So now I'll just get this up here in the corner, hold down Shift while I drag this out. And there on my screen is a nice logo. I can actually center it like that. So it's nicely in the center. It's looking good. I got something using AI and different tools that looks really reasonable. I'm happy with this. This is a new generation. No one else has a logo in the world that looks like this. Okay, do you know what? That's not too bad at all, but I could do with a little bit more excitement. It's two colors. So let's go to gradient mode. And this is where I can really dial things in and get things looking how I want. Now, obviously, I can select from a preset here, or I can go for the kind of sky look. Okay, after a bunch of editing, I'm pretty happy. But if I'm not, I can actually select my logo here and click recolor. Adobe Illustrator has generative recolor, which is really, really cool. If I click into that, I can choose a bunch of sample prompts like this. That is something I'm happy with now after playing around with generative recolor. I'm definitely happy on what I've settled with, so I'm going to save and export. Over here on the YouTube channel, I'll go ahead and select that artboard there. That looks good, perfectly circled there. And that is going to be the logo for my channel. Then I'm going to go ahead and upload the video watermark. This is going to be the transparent version. That's perfect, looking good down there in the bottom right. Now, one thing it's presently missing, it's got the logo there. It's got the watermark going on, but what about a banner image? So this is a quick bonus tip. Let's generate a banner image for my new Creator Magic YouTube channel. Okay, so I've prompted Midjourney secret wizard layer with magic spells, potions, and lots of books full of mystery, experiments, and magical tools. Let's see what comes up. This is intense. Let's try again. So I'm going to upscale that. Okay, we'll get that into Photoshop and turn the opacity down on this little template that gives me a guide so I can see what will show on most YouTube users. And then I just need to do some generative fill around this image, which is just not quite big enough to fit YouTube's full template. So I'm going to select all the areas around the edge of this image, and then I'm going to click generative fill to fill it all in and make it perfect. No prompt here. It's just going to fill in all the extra bits here in my image for my banner. Do you know what? I think I like that one the best. I'm going to stick with that. Go back to the YouTube channel, upload, and let's find that banner. And this is already perfectly showing me what can be seen to most viewers and what's available on the desktop and then the wider area available to TV screens. Now, if you really enjoyed watching how I created the logo for my YouTube channel using AI, you definitely want to watch the next video, which is all about using AI to do face swaps and make epic looking thumbnails. So go on over, watch that video next, and get some awesome thumbnails with your face on using AI.